piper dreams in rings of misty white, knowing in his sleep dreams only keep through the night. As the piper dreams, pretending to perceive, bending dreams to those who dare suppose they'd believe.
Oh, hi, Mike.
Yes,
hi.
Hello.
Thank you for being here today. It's good to see you.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was a nice walk. I haven't been here in a while, this part of the woods. And this is a secluded spot. Except for the air travel up overhead, but not that much. Here's the whir of an airplane. But you wanted me to speak about this aerial event I witnessed when I was hired to shoot something in Brazil for somebody?
Please tell me.
Okay. It's interesting, the story behind this thing, it was like a whole church in a small town in Brazil. The whole church was built around a statue that was found in a little statue of a saint that was found at the bottom of the ocean by some of the fishermen. And when they found the statue, then that year's fishing was very good for them. So in celebration of finding the statue, they built this huge, gigantic church in the little statue's honor. That's interesting, but that's the background why I was there to photograph.
What year was this?
It's probably, must be, either very late 70s or early 80s.
Oh, okay.
I forget, everything's a smear now with the years. But anyway, then after the assignment, I was the cinematographer, so the crew broke up and I was in the car with one of the assistants on making this documentary, of which I was the cinematographer for. And it was in the evening and we were riding back to San Paulo, the city there. And then it was nighttime, and then up ahead you could see faintly in the darkness mountains, forested mountains. But then right overhead, this was like on the front of the windshield, above the mountains in the sky, a light appeared. And it stayed there for, I don't know how long, it stayed stationary above the mountain in the sky, and which was, it was nighttime. And then all of a sudden, I noticed like showers of pixie dust spewing out of the spot of light that was suspended in the sky over the mountains. And this is like right in front of us, up in the sky in the direction we were going, and the mountains were there, and we were on a road, a dark road, a semi, I guess for Brazil, highway or something. And then all this pixie dust was spewing out of the sides of this light in the sky.
Was it huge?
The light, no, it wasn't huge. It was a spot of light just in the sky over the mountains. But the spewing of the pixie dust, it was pastel colored.
Wow.
All of one color, but then it would change all together from baby blue into pink and then into a pastel yellow, and it would just be spewing like a pixie dust.
Wow, gushing.
Yeah, like a waterfall of, you wouldn't say, yeah, sparks, but millions and millions of sparks, but it was like pixie dust.
Wow.
And as it was falling out of around this light,
wow,
in the sky, in the darkness, it would be slowly changing color. And I was fascinated by it. I didn't know how to take it and all. And then the light said to me, like in my head, it said, look, I'm going to blink three times and then I'm going to go out. And it was like a rapport. It was like being in a rapport with what you're seeing. And all of a sudden it gave you a message. It's going to say, I'm going to blink three times and then I'm going to go out. You won't see me anymore.
And you psychically
felt
it.
So I'm just watching it. And in my mind, like, I heard it, it talked to me, like it was in, like, in a psychic way. I mean, there was no voice. I knew it was talking to me, and it's gonna, it said, I'm gonna blink twice, well, three times, and then I'm gonna go out. And then it blinked three times, it flashed three times, and it went out. And that was the connection, and then I didn't know, I couldn't say anything. I don't know, maybe a minute went by, 30 seconds or a minute, and then I said to the girl who was driving the car, we were both in the front seat, I said, you saw that? She said, yes. And there was nothing more to say. And then we started to talk again, but we didn't know how to explain what. I didn't ask her if it had told her too what it told me. But, you know, I had this rapport with it. Like, it knew I was watching it, and it gave me a signal saying it would do that, and it did that after it told me that. So somehow I had connections to this kind of fantastic light in the sky. I mean, what made it fantastic was the pixie dust coming around it and falling from it like a waterfall and changing slowly into these pastel colors uniformly. So, I mean, how do...
So it's like a rainbow waterfall with made out of pixie dust.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
So you weren't scared at all by any of this?
No.
It evoked feelings in you, you said?
I don't know how to explain it. It's just that something appeared in front of you, of us in the sky. And it went through this, it manifested itself in this way. And then it told me what it was going to do, and it went out. Why it was there, I don't know. But why it would speak to me, I don't know. But there was when you see some miracles or strangeness in the sky, you're not just a bystander that is not connected to it. Somehow, you become part of it, its display, and you know about it. It knows you, and there's a communication, and there's a rapport that goes on between you and it. There's an association, but that you become part of witnessing it, and it knows it, and it can speak to you, whatever it was. You see, it's interesting. But then I had to go to an office in Brazil, and then there were all these Brazilian magazines, and there was a lot of articles on UFOs that were happening there in Brazil, which is an interesting kind of afterthought. But I remember. So maybe that was it. I saw something that you might want to call, experiencing something strange in the sky that you have no, that you don't understand. Yet at the same time, you're not detached from it because you participate in the event and that it actually communicates with you. Okay. You know? Yeah. And that was the story with that. It's not my first kind of strange sightings in the sky, but it's one of the most, not the most profound one, but where it started to, you realize something, it was something very, very marvelous that happened. And it could be, you are one of the bystanders who happens to get caught up in the